Today, let's find out how you can save up to 40 hours a week on social media marketing for Instagram by pre-making content and automating posting. We'll show you how to utilize a WordPress site and a special plugin to make this happen, all while increasing traffic to your website. Keep watching to learn how. Hello, my name is Alicia. Welcome to the AliDropship channel. In today's video, we'll tell you all about the Social Rabbit plugin and give you a complete step-by-step tutorial on how to use it. What is Social Rabbit? It's a super powerful WordPress plugin for auto-running social accounts on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and Instagram. What exactly can it do? Social Rabbit can make social media posts using content sourced from your very own site. Blog posts, products imported from AliExpress, and images uploaded to your media gallery. The plugin can even search for free images related to your site and then post these images as content without any work from you. All you need to do is to set posting rules, add promoter actions, add in copy for captions, and the plugin does the rest for you. Social Rabbit takes all the dull repetitive work of posting content for social media off your hands, freeing up your hours of time while helping grow your traffic and sales from social media. After you use this magical plugin, you will never want to run your social media by hand ever again. In this tutorial, we will show you how Social Rabbit works for automating marketing on Instagram. If you want to explore Social Rabbit in more detail or purchase the plugin, I will leave the links in the description box. We'll start this tutorial by walking through the process of creating your account on Instagram. We will then go over installing the Social Rabbit plugin on your WordPress site and setting up the Instagram automation. We will also give examples of how to get your first automated posts. If you already have an Instagram account, then go to this timestamp to start with setting up Social Rabbit. So, first be sure you look at my screen so you don't miss any important details. To start everything, we will need an Instagram account. If you already have one, that's great. Just get your login and password to authorize it within the plugin. As for me, I don't have any account, so I'll have to create one. In order to create an account for my dropshipping store, I'm going to go to the official Instagram website. You can also create an account through the Instagram app on your phone. I need to create a login and password, and then add an email or phone number. Here's a small tip from me. Don't use your name or personal email when setting up your business's Instagram account. Keeping communication and logins that are personal and business separate is always a wise idea. It helps to stay organized. It's also crucial to use your website or brand name as your account name. How else will anyone find you? When your account is ready, you will need to make it look more professional. I'm going to add my store's logo and write a nice bio on the profile for a start. Not sure what to write? Don't worry, I will leave a link to our super detailed article on how to create a mind-blowing bio down below in the description box. Well, my Instagram account is now ready, but to get more promotional features and available on a regular account, I suggest you switch your account to a business one. This is simple to do. To do this though, you will need to have a Facebook page and Facebook business page. In my case, I already have one. You can create this on your own. The process is similar to that of creating an Instagram account. Here's how. Go to the menu in your account and find settings at the bottom of the page. Click settings and then click account. Here you will see the switch to professional account link. Click it. Then just follow the steps Instagram shows you. You will also need the Instagram app installed on your mobile phone, which I already do. My account is ready. Now we can dive into how to set up Social Rabbit. How to install Social Rabbit plugin. When you buy Social Rabbit, you will get an email with a license key and files to download. So let's check my email. That's it. Download the file compatible with your site PHP version and copy the license key listed in the email. Next, go to your website. If you have previously installed any plugin or add-on on your site before, this process should be easy for you. But if you haven't, just watch me demonstrate. Find the plugins tab, click Add New and upload the file you have just downloaded from the email. Wait several seconds. Click Install. Then click Activate. Next, paste the license key in. Okay, we just successfully installed SocialRabbit onto my store. Not hard, right? We have spent about 3 minutes and made about 7 clicks to do that, and it gets better. The settings within the plugin are as easy to follow as the installation process is. We will need about 5 minutes to set up all the functions in SocialRabbit and make our first post. Let's roll! Right now, I'm logged into my online store's backend and I am in the SocialRabbit's dashboard. As you can see, the interface is pretty user-friendly. For today's tutorial, we will only need the Instagram section, so let's focus on that. Here we see a bunch of tools: product poster, gallery poster, stories, blog poster, post grabber, and promoter. Each of them is needed to promote your dropshipping store, and each of them has its own functionality. Product poster is the first tool. Product poster is a huge time saver for dropshipping store owners. This function posts products images for you, allows you to use your own post copy, and lets you schedule posts if you need to, all without manual work. Let's use this option and make our first product post on Instagram. Here you should set the frequency, which is how many product posts SocialRabbit should make per day. Then define the order in which SocialRabbit should post products. Select from New to Old if you want to promote your new arrivals. Select from Old to New if you want to remind your customers about the existing items you have in your store. Or you can select a random order for a mix of the new and old. This is a rather good tactic as well. Next, we need to create a caption. For product posts, it's important to mention the price, shipping, and throw a bit of urgency to get viewers to want to buy. So, let's write a copy template that SocialRabbit can use for our automated posts. To make post creation even easier, there are special field tags which you can use to allow SocialRabbit to auto-populate data from your site to your posts. For example, when I use title, I'm telling SocialRabbit to paste the title of the product into this post. URL is to paste a link to this product. Price is to paste the full price of the item, and sale price is to show a discount price in your posts. Also, you can add the link to your website along with its name with the home URL and site name tags. Tags and tags cat you can add if you want SocialRabbit to use products and category tags as hashtags in your posts. And the last tags are excerpt and full text. Using these tags will tell SocialRabbit to either put part of a product description or a whole description into your post caption. I think for my product posts, I will use title to present the item and price to tell how much the item is. I won't use any URL tags because Instagram doesn't allow users to publish links in captions. And here's my whole copy template with all the necessary tags included. Note that I can also create a variety of captions which SocialRabbit will use randomly for posts. If I wanted to do this, I just need to write different captions and divide each with a slash. Using these signs, I'm telling SocialRabbit to use one of these phrases each per post randomly. There are more cool features here. In my case, I want to activate them all for my store's posts. The swipeable carousel gives my followers a closer look at each item. I will also want to add an active link in bio so that a customer can easily go to my store and buy. And I want my photos to be the right size, so I'll set them to be cropped automatically. Now that I have chosen my settings, let's press Activate and Save. Let's look at my account. SocialRabbit has already published the first post. Doesn't that look cool? No one would ever be able to tell it was an automated post by a plugin. The next tool we'll be looking at is the gallery poster. This function is useful for a dropshipping store because it allows you to use images other than your own product images, such as niche-related lifestyle shots, to change up your posts. This way you are not posting the same images to advertise your products over and over again. To set up this tool, let's take a look at the settings, which look similar to those of product poster. I can set up the frequency, the order in which images will be posted, write post captions. But to use gallery poster, we need to add some pictures to the media gallery of Social Rabbit. Let's do it together. Here's the media gallery. To add images, I can either download them from my computer, import them from Pixabay or from Giphy, or I can set up an automated album. We reviewed the automated album feature in detail in another video, so click the link to it in the description or on the screen. Since I don't have a lot of quality photos for my posts, I will import them from Pixabay. I click this button, paste in relevant keywords for my products, then select the photos I like. When I'm done, I will see all these new pictures imported in my media gallery. Now I have several amazing pictures and can set up the gallery poster tool. I want this type of posts to be posted twice per day. For the sort by for publication, I'm going to select random. In the text template, I will write several phrases and divide them with a slash as I did in the product poster to tell Social Rabbit to use each of these phrases per post it generates. Also, you see here the same field-specific tags for plugin to populate into your posts as I had in the product poster tool. And I'm activating the crop switcher to make my images have the right size for Instagram posts. So now let's look at my account again. Here you will see two different posts with different captions. Of course, you can write as many variations as you want, but don't forget to use a slash between them. Our next tool is Stories. You might have already heard that Instagram Stories are as popular as ordinary Instagram posts and sometimes even more impactful. If you want to increase the engagement of your Instagram account and promote dynamically, I suggest using this tool. As you can see, its settings are super easy. The only thing you should pay attention to is the images in the Stories album in your media gallery. For Stories, we need to add images to a specific album or create a special automated Stories album. This process is the same as we showed with the gallery poster. Then go to the main settings. Here I just have to set the post frequency and save. Next we have the blog poster tool. For this video I'm not going to set it up since our focus is on Instagram. I also happen to not have blog on my website, so this function wouldn't work. But if you have a blog, you can set this tool up to increase the number of readers and visits to your website. The settings for this are pretty similar to that of the other posting tools, so you shouldn't have difficulty setting it up. Next up in our all-star lineup of tools is the grabber. Simply speaking, this tool allows you to automatically repost the content of other users to your account. I like this tool because it makes my account even more human-like while growing my reach. First, like with the other tools, let's set the poster frequency. I don't want to look like a spammer, so I will use this tool only once per day. In order to let Social Rabbit know what content it should repost, I need to add Instagram accounts I like to this section. My store is for women who like to be stylish and fashionable, so based on this knowledge, I'm going to select accounts related to my audience and business niche. With those settings, I present you the first post grabbed by Social Rabbit. It doesn't look out of place in my account feed, and it enhances my overall profile look. The next tools I want to tell you about are Promoter and Mutual Promotion. I combine these two because they serve one goal – to increase the number of likes, followers, comments for your Instagram. To set up the promoter tool, I need to select the actions I want Social Rabbit to do and set up the frequency Social Rabbit will perform this action. And again, I should add the accounts related to my business to this section. Social Rabbit will follow, like, and/or comments these accounts' followers to attract their attention to your account. Mutual promotion is a tool that allows you to increase the number of followers, likes, and comments thanks to SocialRabbit installed on other sites. If an owner of another SocialRabbit activates this feature, his or her rabbit will find your linked Instagram account and both your accounts will start to follow each other while leaving likes, comments on each other's posts. We designed this tool to increase the trustworthiness between social media accounts by gaining likes and followers. The settings of the promoter and mutual promotion tools are exactly alike. They both have three switches you can activate to allow for follows, likes, and comments. Because my store and Instagram account have been just launched, I don't want to activate this tool. It will be very suspicious for followers and for Instagram's algorithm to see that a new account has such a sudden increase in reach, views, and impressions. I'm going to set up these tools now, but will activate them at a later time, maybe in 3 or 4 weeks. And finally, we arrive at the last feature, shoutout. At some point in time, you probably have seen some kind of recommendations from bloggers or influencers' Instagram accounts about a product or a company. This is shoutout, sometimes also sponsorship if disclosed. In one of our previous videos, we covered this kind of promotion at length. You can watch it later by clicking the link on the screen or by clicking the link in the description box. With SocialRabbit, we can make the process of searching for shoutouts easier since we can automate it. When we activate this feature, we start some kind of mass messaging with the shoutout offers directed right into private messengers of different users. To set this up, you will need to write text of this offer, then select accounts that you think are suitable to cross-promote with. Ask about the conditions or terms of other accounts for shoutouts, or suggest your services or products to be featured in a review. It's up to you what strategy to choose. My account is brand new, so it's not established enough to ask for shoutouts. I don't have enough content yet and my number of followers is not impressive. The rabbit will take care about it, but it will take some time. So for now, I set up the tool but won't activate it. We went through a lot of detail about all the functions within SocialRabbit, but you can see with my example account as to how the plugin can populate an Instagram account with such easy content. In just 20 minutes, we can create an account on Instagram, alter it to business account, then install and set up SocialRabbit. You have seen for yourself how convenient and simple all the function settings are. Many are repetitive too, which lowers the learning curve of SocialRabbit. Although we covered Instagram for the purpose of this video, you can easily repeat the settings review today for other platforms such as Facebook, Twitter, or Pinterest, and fill all your social media with content and update your accounts with no effort on a daily basis. I hope I managed to show in great detail how easy it is to run automated promotions for your dropshipping store on Instagram. All you need is the ultra-helping SocialRabbit plugin. If you still don't have the plugin, you can get it by clicking the link in the description box. Once again, this was AliDropship YouTube channel and thanks for watching. Please give this video a like if you found it helpful and be sure to subscribe to our channel to stay on the top of the newest in dropshipping. If you have any questions, ask away in the comments. See you next time. Bye.